So again, this is a modern building table where elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number. Periodic table is the systematic arrangement of elements in the form of table. Modern periodic table was given by Henry. Now, about the groups, I've told you earlier also. Total 18 groups, total 7 periods. Elements which are placed in same group exhibits similar chemical properties. Because the elements which belong to same group are having same number of valence electrons. So here you can say that the elements or the properties of any element is directly controlled by number of valence electrons. Like, if we talk about the chemical reaction between lithium and oxygen, then lithium will form Li2O type oxide every time. If we talk about sodium, then sodium will also form Na2O type oxide. If we talk about potassium, then potassium will also form K2O type oxides. Every time two atoms of group 1 are used up with the oxygen. That's why we are getting Li2O, Na2O, K2O. Reason is very simple, because in the valence shell of lithium, sodium and potassium, we are having same number of valence electrons. So group number gives us idea about number of valence electrons. If valence electrons are same, then properties of the compound will be same. That's why elements are placed in same group. Then about the period number, period 1st, period 2nd, period 3rd, period 4th, period 5th, period 6th, period 7th. Period number gives us idea about valence shell. All those elements which belongs to period number 1, for them energy level 1, energy level 1st will be the valence shell or it will be the outer motion. Elements belongs to period number 2nd will be having energy level 2nd as the valence shell. Period number 3rd, elements belongs to 3rd period will be having energy level 3 as the valence shell. Similarly 4, 5, 6, 7, etc. So whenever we talk about any element, then we must know its group number and period number. Like, if I talk about sulfur, then you must know that sulfur belongs to group 16 and period number 3. Why it is helpful? It is helpful because now you can predict how many total electrons will be there in the valence shell of sulfur and which energy level will form the valence shell. Sulfur, because belongs to group number 16, will be having 16 minus 10, 6 valence electrons. Sulfur is a member of period number 3, so energy level 3 will be the valence shell. Now, some important points related with the periodic table. First point about the atomic size. Clear? Atomic radius is the measure of atomic size. Yesterday only I have told you what do we mean by atomic radius. There I have told you that from the distance from the center of the nucleus to the outer motion. The distance from the center of the nucleus to the outer motion is called the atomic radius. Atomic radius is a measure of atomic size. More the atomic radius, more will be the atomic size. Now, talking about atomic size, when we are moving from left to right. Whenever I am talking about same period, then we will always move from left to right. Whenever we are talking about same group, we will always move from top to bottom. I am talking about period. So whenever we move from left to right in a period, atomic size decreases. Whenever we move from left to right in any period, atomic size decreases. So here we can say atomic size of beryllium will be less than lithium. What is the reason? What is the reason? Reason is very simple. If we talk about lithium, then the atomic number of lithium is 3. Lithium is the third member of periodic table, or the position of lithium in periodic table is 3. So here, first one is your hydrogen, followed by helium, then lithium, and after lithium, we are having beryllium. So atomic number gives us idea about the position of the element in the periodic table, where it will be placed. So, atomic number 3. What do we mean by atomic number? The number of protons or the number of electrons present in an atom is called the atomic number. Remember, in any atom, the number of protons are always equal to number of electrons. Protons carry positive charge. Electrons carry negative charge. So here we can say that the total positive charge will always be equal to total negative charge. That's why atom is electrically neutral. There is no charge over an atom. Now, lithium, because its period, atomic number is 3. So in the nucleus of lithium, we will be having 3 protons. Clear? Electronic configuration for lithium, 2 copper 1, according to Bohr-Mohr scheme. So first energy level is having 2 electrons, and second energy level is having 1 electron. You know it very well that there is a force of attraction between positive charge and negative charge. Because nucleus contains protons, so nucleus will exert a force of attraction over the electrons. Remember, the force of attraction over the valence shell electrons are important. So here is our valence shell. Because the valence shell will decide the atomic radius. And atomic radius will decide the atomic size. Here is your valence shell. Here is the center of the nucleus. This is your distance. This is your radius. Now here, electron is attracted by 3 protons. In lithium, one electron that is present in the valence shell gets attracted by 3 protons. Now, if we talk about beryllium, then in the beryllium will be having 4 protons, and there will be 2 electrons in the valence shell. So when we are moving from lithium to beryllium, there is increase of one positive charge due to increase of one proton. Positively charged particles are increased in the nucleus. Now what will happen? Due to increase in the positive charge in the nucleus, the force of attraction felt by the valence electron will be more. In case number 1, the valence electrons feel force of attraction due to 3 protons. And in second case, the valence electron feels force of attraction due to 4 protons. So naturally, due to 4 protons, the force of attraction will be more. Now what will happen? The valence shell will undergo contraction. The valence shell will come closer to the nucleus. Because nucleus exerts more force of attraction. So here is the contraction in the valence shell or outermost shell, that is your second shell. So whenever we move from left to right, in a period, effective nuclear charge or the force of attraction exerted on the valence electrons increases, that's why atomic size decreases. So it's the rule, whenever we move from left to right in a period, atomic size decreases. Now, the next case, talking about the group. If you move from top to bottom in a group, what will happen to the atomic size? Will it increase? It will increase definitely. It is just reverse. Periodic properties exhibited in the period and properties exhibited in the group are just inverse, just opposite. Clear? Now let us compare between lithium and sodium. Lithium belongs to second period. That's why its valence shell will be the second shell. First and second. Lithium belongs to group number 1. So there will be one valence electron in the outermost shell. Now let us talk about sodium. Moving from top to bottom. Sodium is a member of third period. Sodium is a member of group number 1. So valence electron will remain same. But valence shell will change. In sodium, third energy level will form the valence shell. What is the atomic number? Atomic number of sodium is 11. It means how many protons will be there? In the nucleus of sodium, there will be 11 protons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 protons. Pay heed to this point. In lithium, there were only 3 protons. In sodium, there is increase of 8 protons. 8 protons. Clear? We are increasing the number of protons. So definitely nuclear charge will increase. Then why atomic size increases? Just now I told you in the period, as we move from left to right, the number of protons increases. Due to increase in number of protons, the effective nuclear charge, or we can say the force of attraction on the valence electron increases, and valence shell undergoes contraction and atomic radius decreases. So if we move from lithium to sodium, there is increase of 8 protons. There is increase of 8 protons. There will be increase in effective nuclear charge. Then why atomic size increases? That's the question. Very good. So here, in sodium, according to Bohr-Bodie scheme, we can write electronic configuration as 2, 8, 1. Energy level 1, energy level 2, energy level 3. Third energy level forms the valence shell. So here is your first energy level, here is your second energy level, and here is your third energy level. In energy level 1, we are having 2 electrons. In energy level 2, we are having 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And in outermost shell, we are having 1 electron. No doubt. There is increase in number of protons. But there is also increase in energy level. When we move from lithium to sodium, there is a progressive addition of energy level. So here, dominancy will be of energy level. We have increased one energy level, no doubt. Force of attraction increases, but energy level also increases. So now here, it will be of atomic radius. Just compare. For sodium, atomic radius is more than lithium. Reason is very simple, because we have added one energy level. We have increased one energy level. In lithium, second energy level forms the valence shell, while in sodium, third energy level forms the valence shell. As we are adding new energy level, that's why atomic size increases when we move from top to bottom in a group. So this is about atomic size. Now let us talk about electropositive character. Let us talk about electropositive character. electropositive character, or we can say electromagnetic character. Clear? If we are saying electropositive character, it means I am talking about matter. If we are saying electromagnetic character, then I am talking about non-metals. Metals are electropositive in nature, while non-metals are electronegative in nature. In class 9, you must be told about the classification of matter. Classification of matter, if you remember. Pure substance is classified into two types, elements and compounds. Elements are further classified into four types: metals, non-metals, metalloids and semi and noble gases. Elements are further classified, elements, the pure substances, are further classified into four types: metals, non-metals, metalloids and noble gases. What was the basis of classification? What was the basis of classification? The basis of classification was electron losing or electron gaining tendency. Metals have electron losing tendency. Metals can lose electron, one or more than one electron. That's why metals are called electropositive. Non-metals are having electron gaining tendency. That's why they are called electronegative elements. Metalloids, they can lose electrons or they can gain electron. Noble gases, neither loses nor gains electron. That's why noble gases are called inert gases. So all metals have electron losing tendency. That's why the metals are called electropositive elements. Non-metals are having electron gaining tendency. That's why they are called electronegative elements. Now tell me, what happens to electropositive character if we start moving from left to right? Electropositive character will increase or decrease, or we can say metallic character will increase or decrease. That you have to answer. If we move from left to right in a period, will the electropositive character increase or decrease? Electropositive character will increase. Reason? Decrease. Decrease or increase beyond one point. My question is, if we move from left to right in a period, means we are moving from lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. Electropositive character will increase or it will decrease. Metallic character will increase or metallic character will decrease. Decrease, sure. Now see, what I have told, I have told metals have electron losing tendency. That's why metals are electropositive elements. If a metal can lose electron easily, then it will be called as more electropositive element, more metallic. A metal which can lose electron easily are considered more metallic, are considered more electropositive. Now answer. What happens to electropositive character if we move from left to right? See here. Yes, it will decrease, definitely. See here, just pay attention. This is your nucleus and this is your valence shell. Clear? We have to remove the electron. Now, nucleus, due to presence of proton, exert a force of attraction over the electron. There is a force of attraction present between electron and nucleus. And we have to remove this electron, valence electron, so that we can talk about metallic character. This is case number one. Suppose this is case number one. This is your valence shell. This is your valence shell. Here is your valence electron, and this is the distance. Clear? There might be some force of attraction over the electron. Now, if we move from left to right, atomic size decreases. Atomic size decreases. Valence shell comes closer to the nucleus. If distance between positive and negative charge will decrease, then force of attraction will increase. So in case number one, here is your valence shell, here is your valence electron. In case number second, here is your valence shell, here is your valence electron. So no doubt, in case number second, the force of attraction over the electron by the nucleus will be more. So electrons will be more tightly bound to the nucleus. Electrons will be more tightly bound to the nucleus. So what will happen? Yes, very good. Because when we move from left to right, atomic size decreases due to increase in effective nuclear charge or due to increase in force of attraction. So electron losing tendency decreases. So here we can say that lithium is more metallic than beryllium. Lithium is more electropositive than beryllium. Now when we move from left to right, electropositive character decreases and electronegative character increases. They are inversely related. Clear? Lithium, metal, beryllium, metal, boron, semiconductor, metalloids, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. These are non-metals. These are non-metals. Clear? Now, what about the group? If you move from top to bottom in a group, what will happen to the metallic character? Will it increase or decrease? Increase, definitely. Because when we are moving from top to bottom, atomic radius, atomic size increases. Valence shell goes away from the nucleus. Valence electron moves away from the nucleus due to increasing distance between nucleus and valence electron. The force of attraction will decrease. So release of electron is easy. We can remove electron easily. Clear? So here we can say that sodium is more metallic than lithium. Sodium is more electropositive than lithium. Potassium more metallic or more electropositive than sodium. Similarly rubidium, similarly cesium. Cesium is more electropositive than rubidium. We never talk about francium and radium because these are radioactive elements. These elements emit harmful radiations like alpha, beta and gamma. So dealing with them is highly dangerous. It is very harmful. It can cause cancer, alpha, beta and gamma. If a body comes in contact with alpha, beta and gamma, then it can cause cancer. So we are never dealing with francium and radium. These are the harmful radiations emitted by some unstable nucleus that you will come to know in class 12 if you listen. Clear? They are highly energetic radiations. Like we have UV radiations, like we have X-rays. Clear? Body exposure to X-ray is dangerous. Clear? To UV rays is also dangerous. Similarly, alpha, beta and gamma are there, which are emitted by some unstable nuclei of the atoms. So remember, cesium is the most electropositive element of the periodic table. Done? Fluorine is the most electronegative element of the periodic table. Cesium is most metallic. Fluorine is most non-metallic. Most non-metallic. The most electronegative element of the periodic table is your fluorine. Clear? Then come. What is electronegativity? Electron gaining tendency. What is electronegativity? Electron gaining tendency. Clear? We have to add electron to the valence shell. If valence shell is away from the nucleus, then the incoming electron, the electron which we want to add in the valence shell, will feel less force of attraction. So addition of electron will be not easy. But if the valence shell is close to nucleus, then the incoming electron, which is coming to the valence shell for addition, will feel more force of attraction. So addition of electron is easy. So if an atom can gain electron easily, then it will be more non-metallic. Depends on size. Clear? Electron losing and gaining tendency is not applicable for the noble gases. Group 18, they are excluded because they don't undergo any chemical reaction. That's why they are called noble gases or inert gases. Clear? Yes. Now, the next one about valency. Yes. Valency or valence electron. Valency or valence electron. What happens to number of valence electrons when we move from left to right in a period? Valence electron 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Number of valence electron increases from 1 to 8. What about the group? The valence electron remains same. Now, what is valency? The combining capacity of an atom or an element is called valency. Clear? Now tell me something about the valency. What will happen to the valency? Wait. Can be a valency positive or negative? Can we have valency positive or negative? No, you're absolutely wrong. Valency is never positive or negative. Clear? Remember this point. Because what is valency? Valency is called combining capacity of an element or an atom. How the combining capacity can be negative or positive? Remember, valency is never ever negative or positive. It's simply a number. Some teachers say that metals have positive valency. Absolutely wrong. Some teachers say non-metals have negative valency. Absolutely wrong. Combining capacity cannot be negative or positive. Are you getting my point? Combining capacity जो है वो कैसे negative और positive हो सकती है? वो तो combining capacity है, कोई atom कितने atom के साथ में जुड़ रहा है? That is the valency. And how it can be negative or positive? It's impossible. Clear? Now, about the valency. When we move from left to right, yes. Valency increases from 1 to 4. So here, for lithium, valency will be 1. For beryllium, valency will be 2. For boron, valency will be 3. For carbon, it will be 4. For nitro, it will be 5. For oxygen, it will be 6. For fluorine, it will be... Sorry. For carbon, it will be 4. Clear? It increases from 1 to 4. Then it decreases. So carbon 4, then nitrogen 3, oxygen 2, and fluorine 1. Concept of valency, we never use concept of valency for helium and neon or for the noble gases because they hardly undergoes chemical combination with any other element. Now question is, why valency first increases from 1 to 4, then it shows decrease? See here 1, 2, 3, 4, then 3, 2, 1. Reason? Remember, the octet rule, we can say. The octet rule, you know the meaning of octet rule. Each and every atom tries to have 8 electrons in their valence shell. That's why they are showing sharing of electrons or they are showing transfer of electrons. Yes or no? See, any
NH atomic number is 11. Its configuration is 2, 8, 1. Chlorine's atomic number is 17. Configuration is 2, 8, 7.
Yes or no? Now, sodium wants to complete the octet. Sodium is a metal. Metals have electrolytic tendency. So, sodium ion with electron will form Na plus ion having configuration 2, 8.
Chlorine by gaining one electron forms Cl minus having configuration 2, 8, 8.
So, for octet completion, transfer of electron can be there. Sharing of electron can also be there. Like carbon is having 4 electrons. If it wants to complete the octet, it can share its 4 electron with the 4 electron of other atom. See here.
Hydrogen, sorry, lithium is having only one electron. It is having only one electron available. So only one electron will be involved in bond formation or compound formation. So its valency will be 1. Beryllium, it is having only 2 electrons. So beryllium can use its 2 electrons for compound formation. Boron, 3, it can use 3 electrons, it can use 3 electrons for sharing or for compound formation. Now, carbon comes, carbon having 4, carbon can share its 4 electrons with the 4 electrons of other atom for octet completion, so its valency is 4. Now, about nitrogen. N is having 5 electrons. N is having 5 electrons for octet completion. For octet completion, nitrogen requires only 3 electrons. So nitrogen will share its 3 electrons with the 3 electrons of other atom for octet completion. That's why valency of N is 3. Oxygen, 6 valence electrons.